There is so much to see in The Fringe, but when a show promises to be a pressure cooker of lust, I've got to check it out. Here I am at Latest Bar, and I'm going to meet writer Julie Burchill, Seth Morgan, the director of Hard Times on Easy Street, and see the cast rehearsing.
It's nothing personal to want you dead.
Julie, this is your first musical. Yes. It must be quite different from what you're used to writing.
Yes, it's much more difficult to pull together. So many people working on different things all at the same time. But it's been such a great experience, and that's what every writer lives for, a new experience that they can use in the future.
I absolutely love the title, Hard Times on Easy Street, but I understand that you've tried to use this title for many years now, and at last you've got the opportunity. Tell me about that.
It's very funny. It just came to my mind sometime in the 1980s, and I was always trying to make other people use the title on things they were doing. My then father-in-law had an autobiography out, and I said, you must call it this, and in the end he chose another of my titles, Rebel Without Applause.
Which is also a good
one. That's good too.
So, without giving too much away, can you just give me the gist of the plot?
Well, there's this like rundown nightclub in Brighton, and there's this gay owner of it, and a young singer starts at the club, and I'm afraid she falls in love with him, and these things can get really messy.
Do you think this is going to be the beginning of other musicals by Julie Burchill?
I'd like to think so. The next thing I want to do for next year's Fringe would be a play called Curtain! ! About all the terrible things that can go wrong when you try to put a play on.
The place where the beautiful losers meet. To tell the truth, some don't smell that sweet. But we're happy here on Easy Street.
Hey, Seth, how hard or how easy has it been to direct Hard Times on Easy Street?
It's been a joy. I've got a gorgeous cast. They're all very committed and very clever and very sensitive and perceptive. And the material is so strong, they all crack on with it and get on with it. So I'm a very fortunate director.
I mean, you've done so many things in this industry. You've been an actor and a musician, directed things before. How does this one compare to other things that you've done in the past?
Yeah, so most of my skills have been required for this show in one way or another. It's been in growth for a while. Many creatives have been involved in growing this show, and I'm very grateful to all of them. But, you know, usually I might get to play a bit of guitar, you know, do a bit of dancing. But in this show, I've been at times an accompanist, an editor, a songwriter, a director, an actor. I might still be a bass player at one point. You know, so really, it's only dancing and drumming that are sort of so far out of the loop.
But not
maybe
yet.
We could reel them in.
And working with Julie, I mean, you know, for decades she's been sitting in her, you know, room and writing. Now it's all a bit more sociable.
Yes, indeed. I'm very happy for Julie. And it's wonderful to have the author in rehearsals to, like, check your ideas, you know. And she's just written an absolutely perfect play. It's such a joy. And it's, you know, and it's all based on observation and people. And it's as true as it's funny, you know. It's an extraordinary piece of work. Perfect place to
disappear. Whatever your poison, you'll find it here. You're welcome to Hard Times on Easy Street.
We'll be doing it at the Latest Music Bar on May 21st, 22nd and 23rd. Two performances a night, 6 o'clock and 9 o'clock. And if people come up to me and tell me my name, I'll buy them a drink.
Sounds like a good deal.
Yes.
We're happy here, but we're happy.
You can eat.
But we're happy here.